I don't think so, but we're live here now. Hello, everybody, and welcome to our Saturday morning webinar. Before we begin, I just want to make sure that you can all hear and see us. So if somebody can just put in the text, yes, we hear, yes, we see, just to make sure that everything's running smoothly before we start talking away. Welcome, Donna. Not seeing or hearing anything, Michael put. Okay. Donna or Bill or Octavius from Malaysia, can you hear? It's good to hear from you too, Octavius. Can you hear me? Please just put yes. Hopefully you guys can all hear. I'm going to type it in here. Okay, can you all hear? Hey, Rosanna from the DR, welcome. I need somebody to tell me you can hear me. Hello, hello, hello. Come on, you guys. Okay. Barry, why don't you say something? See if they can hear you.
Hi, everybody. Good morning, everybody. I don't know what time it is in your part of the world, but I got a pretty early Sunday morning here.
They said they can't hear. That's strange. Now can you hear me, everybody? Hello, can you hear? Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Can you hear me? This is Dave Daughtry. Okay, we got Tony on there. He can hear both of us. Wonderful.
Hey,
all right,
good.
So is it Tony in Australia can hear us, but nobody else can. All right. Tony, since you can hear... Okay. Can you see us, Tony, as well? Can you see us on your screen, Barry and I? All right. Are you? Who we got? Okay, Tony. Donna, can you hear? Can you see? Test 1, 2, 3. All right. Tony, can you see us?
Yep, Tony can see and hear. Right, Tony in San Diego.
Tony Kruger, Tony San Diego. All right, Tony, you can see and hear us. They're all going to YouTube.
Who knew you could do that?
Okay. So, Alex, are you able to see us on the video cam as well? Still can't. All right. I don't know what to say. I'm at a loss, and I don't have my tech here, Mason, to help. So the video portion is on YouTube. All right. Test 1, 2, 3. J. Michael Smith, are you able to hear it all? It's frustrating. Test 1, 2, 3. Okay, can you hear Mike? Yeah, Michael? You can finally hear?
Michael can see and hear.
I don't want to be talking away if nobody can hear me. All right, we've got a yes there. So, J. Michael, what did you do in order to be able to hear now? Can you please put in the text what you did so that everybody else can do whatever you did? I don't know if it's with settings or what's going on, but... Yeah, we've got to make sure everybody can see and hear. J. Michael, can you hear me? Hello, hello. Can anybody hear me? Boy, this is really slow. I see we have Luis on there now.
But Luis can't hear.
Click
on
watch
this
video on YouTube. See, I don't even have that option.
No, neither do I.
So, another chat room opens. Okay. Can anybody else hear or see? Hey Barry, why don't you continue on? I'm gonna call Mason real quick and ask if I can figure out what's going on. If you don't mind, maybe do some of the ditto talk part, and we'll just wing it.
Okie dokie. Hi everybody, and as I said to you, I'm not sure what time it is on your part of the world, but I've got like 5-6 o'clock on Sunday morning. So when Dave says to you, are you up for doing a nice early conference call? Of course, you put your hand up, right? That's what we do. So this morning, Dave and I were going to have a little chat together, and we will once we get our sound working better. But what I thought I might do this morning quickly is just to cover a few technical questions that we're getting on Ditto Talk. Like, for example, when can our observers stop using the Puffin browser on their mobile phones or tablets? As you'll know, at the moment, if our observers are watching our Ditto Talk on a mobile or tablet, they're prompted to first download the Puffin browser, right, from their App Store. Why is this? Well, like most of the software in the world, Ditto Talk was originally designed for viewing on a PC or a laptop. And that's still the best way to get the full impact of Ditto Talk for anyone who you're going to get observing this. If you can possibly do it, get them to look at it on a PC or a laptop. Now, many people already have the Puffin browser on their phones, but for those who don't, they need to get that in place before you can view your Ditto. They can view your Ditto Talk presentation. Now, I didn't have it originally on my phone, so I can tell you it's no big deal to get sorted. It just downloads pretty fast from the App Store. But it would work better without our having to ask our viewers to do that, right? So this is why Ditto Talk is spending a lot of time and money on switching the entire Ditto Talk platform over to HTML5 for us. That's the code that makes things work on all devices out there now, on phablets and tablets and phones and everything. When will it be ready? Well, we're told around about the end of March. So we're getting close to the end of March now, of course, so we're going to be going, they are going to be going into beta mode very quickly and very soon on that. So a second question that we keep getting is when our observer is watching on a mobile and using Puffin, why doesn't the blue slider work on the page that selects the monthly amount? Well, it will work when they put the presentation into what's called theater mode. Let me just get it working on my phone for you so I can show you how that works. So they open it up in Ditto Talk. You turn the phone onto its side like so. And then up the top here, there is the little three like that. And you choose, can you see that? Okay. And you choose the theater mode like so. And it locks it into that mode. And then once they've done that, then the slider works, everything works, because basically you've locked that presentation onto their phone, so it works just like it would on a laptop or a phone or on a PC. How many countries can we Ditto Talk into right now? Well, we can Ditto Talk into every country right now. It's just that certain countries like the USA, the Philippines, Australia, New Zealand have the two-click online sign-up. But you can use the generic version for everywhere else and sign people up however you do it now. So you can take people to the end of the generic presentation and then you get out of there. And basically, if your country does online paper sign-ups, then get them to sign that. If you go to the office, take them to the office. All sorts of different ways that you everyone signs different people up in the world. So just go back to the way that you do it now. Other countries will be added to the two-click online sign-up as we move forward, but those countries need to have the ability to have online sign-ups before this can happen. And not every country has that, obviously. So we're working with 4Life. We're encouraging 4Life to get the online sign-up working with as many countries as we can. And as they open those up, we'll add them to the Ditto Talk library of countries. We obviously have many countries in mind for this two-click sign-up. Another question, number four, how can I stay up to date with everything that's happening on Ditto Talk? Well, just simple, just apply to join the private For Life Ditto Talk Facebook page. And this is our community for questions and getting the latest ideas. And we're spreading all sorts of ideas with each other on that. How can I incorporate some of the Ditto Talk ideas into my weekly or monthly meetings? If you go to goforDNA.com, you'll find under the resources menu tab two assets. One is the PowerPoint version of the ProTF presentation. And if you wish, you can download that off that site. Feel free to use any of those PowerPoint slides and you can incorporate them into your meetings. I incorporated them into, I probably used maybe 10 or 20 of those slides and put them into my weekly meeting, my monthly meeting, and changed the conversation to a bit of a Ditto Talk conversation in certain parts of the meeting. It really worked well. I also ran the little video that you'll also find on that Go for DNA site in the resources tab. There's, as I said, there's two assets in there. The other one is the video, a little shortened, a slightly shortened version of the video that we're going to be using on the lead page. And you download that onto your laptop that you're going to be using in the meeting. And if you can prepare a slide on the PowerPoint in your PowerPoint presentation so that the slide activates the video, and you can show that video either at the end or the beginning maybe of your meeting. I made a mistake when I first did it the first time in my first meeting following this. I put it right at the very end. I quickly found that was a mistake because it didn't give me an opportunity to come back in and then invite everybody to come to the product table or to come and talk to whoever about moving forward and giving them some paperwork for joining up and things like that. So if you're going to use it at the end, my suggestion is that you have it maybe two or three slides from the end and allow you to have your normal close for your meeting. One of the things that's really interesting is we're often asked our advice on the best way to follow up after doing a Ditto Talk. Now, of course, the Ditto Talk is just like any other presentation, so the rules on how to follow up from a Ditto Talk are the same as the rules that we'd apply to every other kind of presentation that we would do. Did you know that statistically, 60% of people won't buy our product or join our business for at least 3 months, and that 80% of sales require 5 follow-ups? We're no different from any other industry in these kind of figures. So what's the most powerful part actually of what we do? Yeah, exactly, the follow-up, our follow-up. And what's the easiest and most low-stress way to follow up? Well, I find it's really simple, and this is what we teach in our team. You send them something. Send them something. Email them something. Post them something. Send them to a website. But, of course, email and texting is the simplest way to send something to anybody today. And then the next day, you simply call to see if they got it okay. And then the next question is, have you had a chance to look at it? So you're not ringing to follow up on the presentation. You're now calling to see if they received what you sent them after the presentation. So always make sure you send a little follow-up with a little bit of information. Normally at the end of a Ditto Talk, you can get a feeling for what they are interested in and what further information they can be looking for, and the opportunity really that you are trying to find out that you can send them something so that you can simply give them a call. Hi, Mary. This is Barry. Just following up and just checking that you received what I sent you there yesterday. Did that come through okay? Now, that's a really simple thing to do, right? So you're not asking, were you interested? You know, have you had any time to think about it? None of that stuff. Just ask them, did you receive what I sent you? And did it open up for you okay? Like if it's a PDF file, you might follow up with that question. Did the file open up for you okay? So that's the simplest way we've always found to follow up in our team, you know. It gives you a chance to answer questions as well, of course, because if they did open it up and they did read it and had a look at it, obviously the next question there is, did you have any questions or what did you like? I love that question. What did you like best about what I sent you? Everybody will find something positive to say about that. So you're getting positive answers coming back, positive vibes coming back. Never go hunting for no's, always go hunting for yeses. So what did you like best about it, Mary? I mean, she might only like the heading, right? But she's going to find something that she likes about it, so she'll tell you. Of course, everybody wants to know how the lead page is coming on, right? So here's where we're at. This is the straight-up bully on it. Now, most of you will know that a lead page is a page that simply captures a prospect's name. We call those guys PBPs, by the way, or potential business partners in my Team Diamond group. PBPs replaces the word prospect for us, potential business partners. Anyway, the lead page makes a compelling offer, so the PBPs will give us their name to get what we're offering. In our case, we have the Morgan Freeman video, and that will be sitting up on the page, along with an offer for them to take the Tyler Tate Change Profiling System so they can see what kind of a person they are in response to change. Are they the kind of person that would embrace change or fight change? With the simple profiling system that Dave's had built by this neuroscientist, Tyler Tate, he's developed a series of questions where there are two opposing statements and the person will pull the slider across to whichever statement they agree with for the particular question that they're presented with. And out of that, they will be determined one of four different change profile personalities or types. And they'll receive a nice report automatically once they've completed that. But what we receive is their name, their phone number, and their email address. And of course, what are we going to do with that? Well, of course, we're picking up the phone, right? And we're asking them, first of all, did they complete the profiling system? What kind of profile were they? And then you've got some answers for them to have a conversation with them about that. Okay, so what's holding up the lead page at the moment is this questionnaire. We thought this was going to be the easiest thing to do, but it turns out that it has to be built specifically for everybody who has this kind of profiling system or questionnaire. So we've got somebody building it at the moment. It's been outsourced because it was quite difficult to find exactly the right company and person to create this for us. So we're about 4 or 5 days of receiving this, and we'll be going into a beta testing mode on that. So one of the things I would like to challenge you with here on this little call, sitting right above the Morgan Freeman video is a heading. I would like you to, on the Facebook page, the For Life Ditto Talk Facebook page, let's have a little competition about who can come up with the best headline that we can have sitting above that video. It only wants to be a few words, maybe two lines at the tops, right? But as we all know, that the most important part of any ad that we put out there is the heading. You know, we need to give about 80% of all of our thinking time and often the space on an ad to that heading. It is the single most important thing on the entire lead page or ad or anything that we have running. So how about throwing some ideas? I've got my ideas about what we should have sitting above that video. I won't share that with you at the moment. But just bearing in mind that the speaker in the Morgan Freeman video is offering this Tyler Tate change profiling system that could be worth $1 million to us, to the viewer, for $150, worth $150 for free. So it's a change question. Maybe something like, well, if you have a look at the video, go to the Go for DNA site and have a look at that video, and you'll get a feeling for what they're going to see. So what kind of heading can you think would sit above that? I'll leave you to the thought process without sharing with anything else with you. So you just come up with your own ideas and just put them into the For Life Ditto Talk Facebook page. So Dave, are we back on? Do we have any sound going out there? Was anyone hearing all that good stuff?
Well, yeah, Barry, I guess the challenge was, you know, my account, when it was set up with a different email because I have a business account.
Right.
And apparently YouTube will not accept business accounts. So long story short, I have to sign in on a different email every time. And I had signed in under davidayforlife.com, which is my business account. That's why it won't be embedded. But the stream still works on YouTube. So everything we're saying is still going on to YouTube. They can hear it. But and listen to what you're saying. I just interjecting on a couple of things there. You know, this business is about doing the same thing over and over and over and over and over again, which is, you know, telling the story, talking to people. You know, we're marketers. That's what we do. And as professional networkers, you know, we need to treat this as a business. And that's one of the things I see a lot of people not doing, is they don't treat it as a business. And it's great to get involved, and you've got these illusions of grandeur and making a lot of money and building a massive, you know, organization and having residual income and all these wonderful things, but you still have to treat it like a business in order to get those rewards.
Totally.
Now, there is something here, though, in our business that I love, and I call it the element of mystery, and that is you never know who you're talking to. And I've met people in my career, which now is 35 years in network marketing, where they were successful. They had some success, but it turned out they weren't the ones that really built it. They just happened to get involved at the right place at the right time, talk to one or two right people, and those people took off to build a business, and they were the beneficiary of that, and they made a lot of money. That happens in our business, and I love that. And it'd be wonderful if it happened to all of us, but it doesn't. I don't think it's happened to you, Barry. You've had
to
build your business.
It hasn't
happened to me. Hasn't happened to me either. In fact, let me turn my webcam on here. Hasn't happened to me either. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because you and I, we've had to build what we have, okay? And having to build it, to me, I look at that as being a huge blessing, a huge benefit, meaning that by us having to be engaged and do these things that we've had to do on a daily, weekly, monthly basis to get to where we are today, we've developed skills. I listen to you talk right now. You've developed these skills. And you've got these skills because you went out and you applied yourself and you exercised, if you will, those skills. In the beginning, they were nowhere near as good as they are now. That'd be a safe statement. And so now here you are. You've been networking how long? You've been 20 years?
20 years, yep.
20 years in the industry. So obviously by 20 years of working, you know what you're doing. But the average person that gets on the webinars or joins network marketing, they don't have the experience you have, and they don't have the experience I have. So what is it they need to be doing daily, weekly, monthly? And that's what these calls are going to be about. That's what we're doing here. We're trying to get people to understand that every day, you know, you work your list to start off with. I had a yellow pad. Now, I know today people, you know, it's on your computer. People have CRMs. They've got their smartphones or iPhones, whatever, you know. And so the point is that with me being old school, when I started, you know, this is 1998, of course, there was no iPhones existed back in 98. And so it was having a yellow pad of paper, and I documented the day. If I talked to Barry Blake, which I did back in 1999, I think it was, Barry, you know, I kept notes, and you and I developed a relationship. We talked on the phone numerous times. And finally, if I recall, you asked me if I would come over to New Zealand to do a meeting. I saved up a bit of money and I went there and I did a meeting at the Waipuna Hotel, I think it was. And you actually filled it. They had a little stadium in there, and you had a lot of people come.
I got 450 people to come and see you, Dave.
That's right. So now here's the thing. The reason I followed you is because of the relationship we developed in the beginning. A, you were a networker. I could tell as we talked, you talked about your past experience. B, you're with the company Care International. I can say the name now because they're gone. You know, you're with Care. You were marketing Pycnogen, all pine bark at the time. And so you knew network marketing. You were experienced. You were hungry still. You had a team already that was looking for a home. I mean, that's like hitting up, you know, the mother lode if you're looking for gold, you know? So there's a game we play in this business called follow the leader. All right. I followed you to New Zealand. I did the same thing with other people like Sherry Din in Malaysia. You know, Jeff Altgilbers here in the U.S. If somebody names a platinum or they name, you know, a top leader in my organization, I know the story. You know, I know when they signed up, how they signed up. I was involved. I'm not going to say with every single one, but probably 95% of the leaders close to me, I was engaged and I was involved. So I would say, number one, you have to be engaged and involved in your business every day. Document who you're talking to and take notes of pertinent information. If, like when I talked to you, Barry, you know, there were certain things we had in common. You know, now I don't like cats, but you're a cat lover. Right. I knew that from the beginning because you'd have your cat sitting on your computer all the time.
I did.
You know, they'd be sitting on your keyboard.
And here's something we had in common, Dave. Do you remember? This little beast.
That's right. The guitars.
This little beast.
You know, I remember you in the house and playing your guitar. You know?
In fact, Dave, can I just share a little quick story?
Yeah.
The first time I met this guy, I picked him up from the airport. And I had just had the frets on my guitar reworked by a mechanic, a guitar guy. And it was in the back of the car. So Dave throws his bags in the back of my station wagon. And he eyes up my guitar and he says, "Oh, man, what do you got there?" I said, "I've just had the guitar reworked. The frets should be really cool. It's a beautiful guitar." And the first thing he did was he went like this.
Peel my nails off.
And he bit all his nails off his left hand. I said, "What are you doing?" He said, "Oh, man, I haven't cut these for a little while. I've got to play your guitar." And we hadn't even moved. He went around and got my guitar, and he started playing this guitar in the back of my car. And I got to tell you, he's a good guitarist, this guy. He's got all sorts of skills in the back of there. I tell you, and he can sing a bit as well. All good. So what a bonding, you know, like really straight off. We were just like soulmates in the music side of things. And this is what I find every single time I talk to somebody, even if it's just over the phone for the first time, it only takes about 30 seconds before you can find something in common with a person. You know, it's amazing how we can quickly get to a point of commonality. And if you're just talking about anything at all, there'll be something that links back to something that you can say you know something about it. And hitting those commonalities, hitting those common points is really I think is one of the original skills in talking to people. And that's a bit about what the colors, of course, are about on the Ditto Talk, at the beginning of the Ditto Talk, the red, yellow, blue, and green. If you can find out a bit about what a person's doing, you can quickly get some common point to talk about. So for Dave and I, it was guitar work.
The reason that's so important, too, is that, you know, when you talk to someone, understand that 90% of what you say about transfer factor or for life or the pay plan, whatever it may be, the majority of it goes in one ear and out the other. They don't pick up that. But what they do pick up is how they feel about you as a person. And there's exactly. People listening in online right now, like J. Michael Smith, which I've talked to on the phone numerous times. And I've talked to many of you. You know, Octavius, we've met there in Malaysia. And you're all very personable. It's very important to know that people buy us first. So when you are talking to someone, don't worry about everything you say, about saying the perfect things. Doesn't matter. As long as they know it's coming from your heart and you sincerely care about them as a person and their success. If they realize you care And you can play this card. I played it all the time. I would tell a person, look, I'm building a business. I'm inviting you to build it with me. All right. And I would say, come on, I'm going to climb this mountain. And I even tell some people, I'm going to climb it with or without you. So let's do it together. Let's build the business and have fun doing it. Be successful. All these wonderful things. If you present it the right way, and you remove their fears, you remove their objections, they're going to want to get involved. And so, you know, going back to the early days, to me, it was a huge blessing to have to do things the old-fashioned way, because it forced me to develop these skills. Nowadays, we live in a world that's fast and furious, and everybody thinks that everything has to just happen fast. Building a network of people takes time. And so, but you can still speed that process up by A, keep documenting what you're doing and going back and following up with your people and knowing, you know, when you're beating a dead horse. You know, there are times where I've called people up and I realized immediately, you know what, this isn't going anywhere. And I just move on next. And I put them on the back burner. You know, it doesn't mean I tear up the paper and throw it away. Things change. People change. Barry, how many people have you talked to where they weren't interested at one day? You talk to them a week later, a month later, all of a sudden they're interested.
Often. And, you know, Dave, we develop skills that we never had before as well. And I think this is possibly one of the major blessings of this business for me, is that I was a chronically shy person when I was younger. I mean, it was debilitating for me. It held me back through my entire school life. I was the bullied guy because every time someone looked at me, I just changed the color of your shirt. Man, I tell you, if the teacher asked a question at the front of the class and she started looking around, I'm over here, right? But I mean, if I knew her gaze was going to come across to me. And the nearer the gaze got to me, the redder and redder I became. She may not have even been thinking about asking me, but all of that was in my head. This runs in my family. You know, it comes down to me from my older folk who before me. And so one of the biggest challenges I have always had is, had a long time ago now, is to overcome my shyness. And why I think this business was built for me and my shyness is that I had to speak to people. I simply had to. So I said to my wife one day, Sue, I said, how am I ever going to get to talk in front of people? And we determined that I had to go and take a course in public speaking, like a private course. And so I did that. And I couldn't even stand up and speak in that private course. Like, there was only six or seven of us in this room, and I couldn't stand up and speak in front of these other people. That's how bad it was. I can remember being in a place once where Sue and I went to learn how to bring kids up. You know, we all have children, right? But the one thing none of us are taught is how to bring children up. So we went to this EastCare parenting course, and we were sitting in a lounge with other parents, and the room was darkened, and we were sitting on the floor. It was a very casual atmosphere. And it came my turn to speak about who I was and who our kids were. And I went to speak and nothing came out. Like, I'm talking, all I could do was squeak. So that's where I come from. And this business has made it totally possible for me to confront the biggest weakness that was holding me back in my life, which is not communicating. If you can't communicate with other people, if anybody's ever done a landmark forum, you know, enrolling people into your life and into your ideas is the single biggest skill that we have to develop in life. Otherwise, nobody can be a leader without followers, right? You can't be a leader without a group. So if you can't speak to other people and give them your ideas, how on earth can you have a follower? Until you've got a follower, you're not a leader. So I had to work this all through, and I have got to the point where, without even my heart pacing up one extra pump a minute, I've gone out and spoken to 2,000 people on a stage. That's where I've come from, and that's where I am now. And that's taken me years to get to this. It may seem very casual, me talking to you now, but let me tell you, this has been a hell of a journey to get to this particular place. So all I'm sharing this about is that you don't have to be perfect at all when you start doing this. But trust me, this process of this business will develop skills in you that will benefit you in every other part of your life as well. So anyway, I just wanted to share that for anybody who thinks they can't speak to people. Let me tell you, you can. It's just you're not quite there yet, but this business will help you do that.
Well, and it starts too by talking to the people that you know. That's why we say warm market. Yep. You know, we understand that when you go to your warm market, especially if you're the quiet person, the shy person, the bullied person, whatever it may be, you go to your warm market, and the reality is they're going to criticize you. They're going to judge you because they've looked at you a particular way their entire life or since they've known you. And that's how they see you, in a particular box. They might look at you and think, oh, you're introverted, you're this, that, whatever it may be. But they already formed an opinion of you, all right? So now they have that opinion. You're coming at them with something completely different. Network marketing. You're going to build this business. And they look at you like, yeah, right, all right? Well, use them as practice, all right? Be a good leader with your family, friends, and neighbors, the people that you know. You go to them, you tell them what your intentions are, what you're doing. Trust me on this one, you guys. By doing that, it does a couple of things. One, it puts them in a place to where they cannot come back at you and say, oh, why didn't you ever tell me about this business you were doing? Because all of a sudden, you're working with people. You're helping other people be successful. Barry, I've worked with you for a long time, you know, and we've worked together and helped build your organization, done the same thing with other people around the world. Well, all of a sudden, people that know you say, what about me? I'm over here. Why aren't you working with me? Well, the reality is you told them in the beginning and they weren't interested, you see. So you can put that back on them. And that's what I've done with my family for probably, gosh, I'd say a decade in 4Life. My family and friends did nothing. They weren't interested. Well, then when they saw me living the life of luxury, you know, driving around, flying around in my new cars and the new house I built and traveling the world, they all become interested all of a sudden. You know, it's a funny thing. Everybody wants to be successful. All right. They all want it, but who deserves it? And that's another point. Between, you know, understand when it comes to family, friends, and neighbors, they're going to be the hardest on you. They're going to want the most out of you. They can be the most draining. So here's what a good leader does. Barry, this is what happened with you. We met. I didn't know anybody. We got Bill on the line. Bill Perrins, I believe, is on here. Bill's in New Zealand as well.
Yes.
All right. So this is a good example. I didn't know Bill. I knew you. But as soon as I got to New Zealand, the first thing you did was introduce me to Bill and a lot of your other leaders. Well, rather than me saying, oh, great, you know, I'm shaking hands, you know, and I just, you know, talked to Barry Blake and never even, I engaged with those people as well. You see, talking. And then when I came home, I stayed engaged, talking on the phone, through emails, whatever it may be. Why do we do that? Well, Barry, if you had dwindled and just disappeared on me, I at least now had a relationship with the people that know you, you see. And the funny thing is those people that we don't know, you can develop a relationship faster, easier, stronger than the people that you know, honestly. And we're talking about the business, 4Life, okay? Granted, the people that know you, you know them, you got a long history together. But believe it or not, when it comes to this business, the people that you don't know are going to be the ones that listen to you the most. It's just the way it is. It's because they can't judge you. So now what you have to do, put that hat on, that leadership hat, and do things you may not be comfortable doing. They can't judge you. Get used to that. You see, you can do and say whatever you want, and they can't judge you. So you can come across like you've been in this industry for 100 years, you know, and you know 4Life inside and out. And you know, now obviously you don't want to come across as being belligerent or rude, but you can come from a position of strength. Now, Barry, I watched you on stage when I got to the Waipoon and we did that event. You just took control. You just got right up there and talked to your people, and then you introduced me and I did the rest.
That's right. You know? Well, and actually, Dave, of course, that's what one of the strengths of the Ditto Talk program is about. You can appear very professional, straight out of the box. I mean, I've decided to have a bit of a chest before I die. You know, like I've been a skinny guy all my life and I want to put a bit of muscle on. So I've got a personal trainer who I am with 8 o'clock every weekday morning. And Jono is his name. And he did his very, he joined. Well, no one's going to come near me and not join, right? That's the way it is. That's what Dave was just talking about. We connect with people and they get enthusiastic about our lifestyle. And when everybody else is rushing in and out trying to get to the gym before 5:30 before they go to work at 7:30, I mean, I stroll in at 8 o'clock. My wife Sue and I do. So Jono takes notice of all these things. He joined up. His very first ditto talk that he did, the guy joined. Now, Jono didn't know much about 4Life at that particular point. He knew a lot about ProTF because that was his area of getting his customers. But man, I'll tell you what, he was totally blown away. This very first ditto talk presentation and the guy signed up. So that's a really powerful way to appear professional right out of the box. And that's the magic of ditto talk.
Right. And you need to practice your ditto talks as well. Again, this is where family, friends, and neighbors come in handy. You can call any of them up and say, hey, I started a new business and I've got this incredible tool I'm using now to share it with people. Can I show you what it is? Now, if your family, friends, or neighbors, people that know you real well, say, no, I don't want to know. They're not your family, friends, or neighbors. That's my opinion. Okay. You know, I can call up anyone that knows me and say, look, you know, I've got something here I want to show you. Take a look at it. I'd like to get your opinion. People like to give opinions all the time, right? Granted, don't take up the entire day. You take 20 minutes of their time and you do a little ditto talk. It gives you practice. You're going to learn. They're going to question you. They're going to ask things. Let them. They might be tough on you because they know you and they can be. When you're talking to a stranger, generally they're not nearly as tough because they don't know you. They don't know how to be tough on you. Granted, they might ask questions. If you don't know the answers, you might come across as being looking a little foolish, but you know what? That's okay. I looked real foolish in the beginning, and Barry, you might have too. We didn't know about the transfer factor. We didn't know. We were learning, you know? But the funny thing is, while we were learning, we were still talking. You know, that's how we got better. You know, that's how we became masters of talking about transfer factor and 4Life. And back then, we didn't have ditto talks, and we didn't have these webinars, and we didn't have all the tools we have today. So it came down to our ability to talk. Our ability to market with our mouths. And that's a great skill to have.
That's right. It's actually a very repetitive business. And lots of people try and overwork it. They try to overthink it. It's really quite simple. If you did one or two ditto talks every single day of the year, you're going to have a share of the $200 million that are paid out in commissions into our industry every day. Do one or two of those a day. Like that's 365 or 700 presentations a year, Dave, that's going to work, right?
That's right. You know, and you need to understand too, when you're talking to people, ditto talk, it has all the, you know, the buzzwords, the phrases, the graphics, it's loaded with everything that you need to be sharing with people. But again, understand that that is one tool, one element in the whole process of building your business. Okay. Ditto talk is very professional. And you can come across, if you've practiced, you're coming from that position of strength that we're talking about with the person, okay? After doing a few ditto talks, you don't have to know it word for word. You know, you'll know the basics of it. You'll be able to look at your screen where the text is. I can look at it, and I know where it's going. And I may not say every single word exactly as it's written, but I get the phrase down just right because I know what I'm talking about, you see. That's when it flows smoothly. That's when... You know, everything's natural when you're talking to people. When that happens, you know it because all of a sudden you find yourself not necessarily reading. You're just following, you see. You're just going along with what's there on the script, but you know what to say because it's already in your mind.
Now, exactly. And I think once you've done maybe 10 or 12 or 20 ditto talks, you own it. You recognize when the line's coming up. I mean, even now when I'm doing it, I leave out the person's name sometimes because it didn't feel quite right. In that line when I'm speaking to that person, sometimes I put more, I call her Mary more often or less. So you end up making each line your own. It only takes about 10 or 20 and you've personalized it for yourself in your own mind. So there you go, Dave. That's 45 minutes, Dave. So we've done our bit, man.
Well, you know, before we finish here, just a tip of the day, you know, document everything you're doing in your business, whatever CRM you use. I don't care if it's Outlook, Act, Yellowpad, whatever it may be that you use, you know, Word, whatever it is. But the whole point is you need to look, you can't manage what you don't measure. All right. So keep track of what you're doing in your business and who you're talking to, because you might talk to someone and plant a seed, and then you wonder why a year later, 2 years later, they show up at an event somewhere. You know, you didn't follow up. Somebody else did. Somebody harvested the seed you planted. So go back and continue to follow up with your people. You guys, we'll have you on next week. We are going to be sharing some new things with you coming up here. The intention today was to do that a little bit, but I've decided we're going to hold off because we want lead pages to come out. So everybody will have lead pages soon. Okay. We apologize for the delay, but hey, that's IT stuff, you know, but it's coming out, and then we'll be unveiling a couple other things that will help you propelling your business forward. Thanks, everyone. Have a fantastic week, and we'll talk to y'all real soon. Barry, thank you very much.
Thanks, everybody. Cheers. Bye, Dave. Cheers, everyone.